just hit the subscribe button, the red button, underneath this video over to the right, and that'll sign you up on my YouTube channel. And then you can hit the small bell icon, so a little bell will go off and tell you each time I've started to broadcast a new one. I hope you enjoy it. One of the mysteries that lingers from 50 years ago is, why did Mark Felt, the deputy director of the FBI, become Deep Throat, the guide who led Woodward and Bernstein through the Watergate scandal and ultimately was responsible for the resignation and almost impeachment of President Richard Nixon? What impelled this massive, unbelievable leak from the Nixon administration, where literally Felt, known as Deep Throat, which is how Woodward and Bernstein described him in their news stories, would meet with Woodward and Bernstein in a parking garage in Washington and would coach them through their stories, analyzing what information they had, supplying new information, confirming the trails they were on, warning them off false trails. And in the course of that, he gave one memorable quote that has survived in American history: follow the money, meaning follow the payoffs that were made to try to cover up the Watergate burglary. Why did he do it? Without him, there's no doubt that Woodward and Bernstein would not have been able to pursue their stories, and Nixon would not have been impeached or removed from office or resigned. Well, there are all kinds of theories that abound about it, but the one that seems to make the most sense is that Felt was the deputy director to L. Patrick Gray, who was Nixon's appointee as director. Now, director of the FBI now sounds just like another job, but at the time it was the equivalent to being the King of England. J. Edgar Hoover had occupied that job since the late 1920s, 20s through the late 60s, a span of more than 40 years, in which he built up the FBI to incredible heights of prestige. Serial dramas were entitled The FBI, and they fostered an image of the FBI that was probably way out of proportion to its effectiveness. The Bureau celebrated its capture of John Dillinger and of Al Capone and all kinds of legendary bandits. And sending in the FBI seemed to be the equivalent of the ultimate you could do in crime fighting. And with that legacy in mind, when Hoover suddenly had to leave, Gray, who was appointed to fill his place, looked like he was inheriting a massive empire. And Mark Felt, who had toiled away in obscurity as Hoover's deputy, was outraged by that. He felt, no pun intended, highly resentful, and was determined to try to get even with Gray. So he leaked this stuff, which basically implicated the FBI in Nixon's cover-up of Watergate, not with the goal of getting Nixon, but with the goal of getting Gray. Felt achieved his immediate goal of getting rid of Patrick Gray as FBI director, but then Nixon turned around and did not appoint Felt to the job, but appointed Ruckelshaus, who served as head of the FBI. And the speculation is that Nixon learned that Felt was in fact Deep Throat, and that that was a reason for passing him over for appointment. After Ruckelshaus took office, and Felt initiated and was involved in a whole series of break-ins of the families of Weathermen underground leaders. The Weathermen was a gang of left-wingers who committed outrages and bombings and attacks and crimes and were in hiding. And Felt broke into their home, the homes of their relatives, looking for information to try to track down the underground. He didn't succeed. It didn't lead to any arrests, but it did lead to his own indictment for orchestrating the break-ins. He was indicted, tried, and convicted, and fined, I think, $5,000, no imprisonment. And in 1981, on taking office, President Ronald Reagan pardoned Felt. But the amazing thing was that through this all, through his arrest, his indictment, his trial, his conviction, his efforts to secure a pardon, Felt, who had rendered this unbelievable service to American democracy, putting his own career and life at risk to oust a corrupt president, never revealed his role as Deep Throat. He didn't tell anyone who it was until 2005, at the age of 92 years old, that he finally revealed that he was Deep Throat at the promptings of his daughter. Until then, he labored in obscurity, suffered the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, and never revealed his secret. Thanks for watching.